issue, dear? Why are you holding back from such a man? Is it the clumpy way he walks?
Or the grumpy way he talks?
Or the pear-shaped, square-shaped weirdness of his feet?
And though we know he washes well, he always ends up sort of smelly.
But you'll never meet a fellow who's as
sensitive and sweet. So he's a bit of a fixer-upper, so he's got a few flaws.
Like his peculiar reindeer,
his thing with the reindeer
that's a little outside of nature's laws.
So he's a bit of a fixer-upper, but this we're certain of: you can fix this fixer-upper up with a little bit of love.
Can we please just stop talking about this? We've got a real, actual problem here.
I'll say. So tell me, dear, is it the way that he runs scared,
or that he's socially impaired,
or that he only likes to tinkle in the woods?
What?
Are you holding back your fondness due to his unmanly blondness,
or the way he covers up that easy, honest goods?
He's just a bit of a fixer-upper. He's got a couple of buds. His isolation is confirmation of his desperation for healing hugs. So he's a bit of a fixer-upper, but we know what to do. The way to fix up this fixer-upper is to fix him up with you.
Enough! She is engaged to someone else, okay?
So she's a bit of a fixer-upper.
That's a minor thing.
Her quote, engagement is a flex arrangement.
And by the way, I don't see no ring.
So she's a bit of a fixer-upper, her brain's a bit betwixt. Get the fiancé out of the way, and the whole thing will be fixed.
We're not saying you can change him, cause people don't really change. We're only saying that love, of course, is powerful and strange. People make bad choices if they're mad or scared or stressed.
Fixer that can fix a fixer-upper is
true.
Do you, Anna, take Christoph to be your trollfully wedded?
Wait, what?
You're getting married.